Yes. Please tell what chapter to complete first for revision. Yeah, that I will let you know. Beta. So shall we start? Sir, kindly take custom duty class if it is possible today. How many of you are from old syllabus, beta? How many of you are from old syllabus? How many of you are from old syllabus, beta? One, two, three, four. Old syllabus only. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Beta, only old syllabus. 12, 13, 14. Okay. Okay. Just enough. Now you tell me, what should I do? Should I take amendment or should I take your query? Should I take amendments or should I take query, beta? Margin relief is not possible and not important from exam point of view. Amendments. Amendment, then doubts. Fine. Let's start with amendment. We have already done with salary. We have already done with house property. Then amendment number one. Taxability of gift. Read with section 9. Income deemed to accrue or arise in India. Income deemed to accrue or arise in India. Just write it down, beta. Taxability of gift, income deemed to accrue or arise in India. First, quickly recap regarding taxability of gift. Taxability of gift. Person who provide the gift is known as donor. Person who receive the gifts is known as donee. Donor provide gift to donee. Under old provision, donee may be any person. Individual, HAF, company, firm, AOP, any person. Under old provision, donee may be any person. Donor must be. I'm talking about latest amendment only, beta. Any person. Earlier only individual and HAF is covered, but from Finance Act 2018 and onward, donor may be any person, individual, HAF, company, donee may be any person, aapka individual, HAF, company, firm, any person. Gift is categorized into three category: gift of money, gift of movable property, gift of immovable property. Gift of money, gift of movable property, gift of immovable property. Donor may be any person. Donee may be any person. Gift should be of either money or specified movable property or immovable property if it exceeds ₹50,000. Fair market value exceeds ₹50,000. Stamp value exceeds ₹50,000. Then entire value shall be taxable in the hands of Donee. Then entire value, if money gift is 55,000, then entire 55,000 is taxable in the hands of Donee. If movable property FMV is 60,000, then entire 60,000 is taxable in the hands of Donee under the head other source. Under the head other source. If money value exceeds 50,000, entire value taxable. If FMV exceeds 50,000, then entire value shall be taxable. If stamp value exceeds 50,000, then still entire FMV shall be taxable. And taxable in the hands of Donee under the head other source. Taxable under the head Donee under the head other source. Major amendment by Finance Act 2019. Income deemed to accrue or arise in India in case of gift, deemed, assuming accrue or arise means earn. Income deemed to be earned in India in case of gift. In case of gift, क्या कहता है बेटा ये? An income which satisfies all the condition. An income which satisfies all the condition is deemed to accrue or arise in India accordingly taxable in India. An income which satisfies all the condition is deemed to accrue or arise in India accordingly taxable in India. Accordingly taxable in India. Number one, income arising outside India. Income arising outside India. Number two, income is in the nature of gift. Income is in the nature of gift of money, money only. Here movable property is not given, immovable property is not given, only money would be covered. Number one, income arises outside India. Number two, income must be in the nature of gift of money only. Within bracket, movable property and immovable property are excluded. Only money is included. Only money is included. Money is being paid by. Money is being paid by resident. Money is being paid by resident in India. It means donor must be resident. It means donor must be resident. Fourth, money is being paid to money is being paid to non-resident. It means donor must be resident and donee must be non-resident. Donor must be resident, donee must be non-resident, and such payment is made. Such payment is made on or after 5th July 2019. Date when finance bill become the finance act. Date when finance bill become the finance act. If all of the above five conditions are satisfied, such gift income shall always taxable in India. Although it is received by a person who is non-resident in India, but such income shall deem to accrue or arise in India accordingly, always or always taxable in India. So point number one, there must be income outside India. Income must be in the nature of money only. Movable property and immovable property are excluded. Only money is covered under section 9. Money is being paid by resident in India. Money is being paid to non-resident in India. Such payment is made on or after 5th July 2019 and money amount must exceeds by rupee 50,000. If all these points are satisfied, then such gift shall deem to accrue or arise in India, although receive outside India, but such gift shall deem to earn in India accordingly, always taxable in India. Diagrammatic form mein beta, donor must be resident, donee must be non-resident, gift of money outside India, gift of money outside India after 5th July 2019 exceeds ₹50,000. Then what shall be the answer? Taxable in the hands of donee. Under the head other source. Taxable in the hands of donee under the head other source. If any one of the condition is not satisfied, then gift shall not be taxable in India. If any one of the condition is not satisfied, then such gift in my example, then such gift shall not be taxable in India. I hope you are getting the issue. This is the first major amendment in taxability of gift. Any ifs and buts one by one, but I am teaching you direct taxation and you are continuously talking about GST. What's due with income tax? If time spare, then we'll consider beta. I hope you are getting the issue. Shall I move on? This one is page 1. Next beta. Chapter 6A deductions. Chapter 6A deductions. I am taking important deductions later on amendments. I am taking beta important deductions later on amendment. First and most important 80D. First and most important beta 80D. This one is most important from exam point of view. No amendment is there, but I am considering only because it is more important beta. ATD, health insurance premium. Health insurance premium, popularly known as Mediclaim. This one is most important from exam point of view, beta. Health insurance premium and medical claim. Who is eligible for deduction? Eligible assessee. Individual or HEF. Whether resident or non-resident. Individual and HEF is eligible for deduction whether resident or non-resident. What should I do to claim the deduction, beta? What should I do to claim the deduction? Eligible amount / investment. Eligible amount / investment, invest towards, yeah, payment towards health insurance premium. Or payment towards preventive health checkup. फर्स्ट बेटा आपका, फर्स्ट आपका हु इज एलिजिबल फॉर डिडक्शन, इंडिविजुअल और एचएफ, वेदर रेजिडेंट और नॉन रेजिडेंट. व्हाट शुड आई डू टू क्लेम द डिडक्शन बेटा? आई शुड मेड द इन्वेस्टमेंट, इन्वेस्टमेंट इन मेडिकल इंश्योरेंस ऑल्सो नोन एज हेल्थ इंश्योरेंस प्रीमियम, और पेमेंट टूवर्ड्स प्रिवेंटिव हेल्थ चेकअप, और पेमेंट टूवर्ड्स प्रिवेंटिव हेल्थ चेकअप. व्हाट इज द अमाउंट ऑफ डिडक्शन? What is the amount of deduction? Any idea? What is the amount of deduction? Just write it down. Just write it down. We have two category. Category A. Category B. We have two category, category A and category B. Just write it down. Just write it down. In case of category A, in case of category A, who is covered under category A? Who is covered under category A? Assessee himself, spouse, children. Children may be dependent, children may be independent, children may be minor, children may be major. Category A, assessee himself, spouse and their children. Assessee himself, spouse and their children is covered under category A. Is covered under category A. Category B, parents. Category B, parents, and most important thing, and most important thing, parents must be dependent. Most important thing, beta, parents must be dependent. In case of spouse or children, they may be dependent or independent, but parent must be dependent on assessee. parent must be dependent on assessee. Now take these three person, entire category A, total premium paid or rupee 25,000 total premium for all three assessee spouse and their children. Total premium paid or 25,000 whichever is less shall be allowed as deduction. Total premium paid or 25,000 whichever is less shall be allowed as a deduction. However, if any of the above mentioned person, is a resident age 60 year or more, then deduction shall be actual premium paid or rupee 50,000 whichever is less. So basic principle, actual premium paid or 25,000 whichever is less. This one is basic principle, actual premium paid or 25,000 whichever is less. However, if any of the person is resident senior citizen means age 60 year or more. If any one of the person is resident, highlight the word resident, senior citizen, then instead of 50,000 shall be taken into consideration. I hope you're getting the issue. I am talking about premium only. I am not talking about preventive health checkup. Health insurance premium. Sir, what is the treatment of preventive health checkup? We'll let you know later on, beta. This is all about health insurance premium. This one is category A. Category B. Exact same. Total premium paid or 25,000 whichever is less. Shall be allowed as a deduction. However, if any person is a resident senior citizen, then limit is 50,000 instead of 25,000. Exact same beta. Category A, actual premium paid or 25,000 whichever is less. Category B, actual premium paid or 25,000 whichever is less shall be allowed as a deduction. However, if any of the person in any category, is 60 year or more, then limit shall be, just hold on. Hello. Hanji. Beta, main aapko ek bar ek ghante mein khud call back karun, actually online class le raha hu. Ha, category A, extremely sorry beta. Category A, actual premium paid or 25,000 whichever is less shall be allowed as deduction. However, if any person is of age 60 year or more and resident, then limit is 50,000. Same with category B, 50,000 limit is available only when person is resident. If person is non-resident, then in that case limit would be 25,000. If a person is non-resident, then limit would be 25,000. Example. Mr. X paid health insurance premium on health of following person. Number one, self. Mrs. X, $12,000. Dependent daughter, $9,000. Independent son, $6,000. Father, 62-year resident. Premium. This one is premium. $28,000. Mother, 60-year non-resident. 25,000. Grandparents, dependent and resident. Premium paid 40,000. Compute deduction under section 80D. Make it fast. Compute deduction under section 80D. This one is comprehensive example. Category A, self always covered. How much is the premium? $10,000. Spouse always covered. How much is the premium? $12,000. Dependent daughter always included. Children always included. Whether dependent, independent, major, minor, whatever. $9,000. Son, always included, whether dependent, independent. So this one is category A. Total premium 10, 12, 22 or 9, 31 or 6, 37. So deduction under section 80D. $37,000 or $25,000, whichever is less. $25,000. This one is category A. This one is category A. Any ifs and buts in category A, beta? Any ifs and buts in category A? Category B. Parents, father. Question is silent, assume dependent. How much is the premium? $28,000. mother, how much is the premium? 25,000. Father is resident senior citizen. Father is resident senior citizen, but mother is non-resident senior citizen. Both are senior citizen. One is resident, another is non-resident. No matter, beta. If any one of the person is resident, if any one of the person is resident, then deduction, beta, 53,000 or 50,000, whichever is less. Category B, आपका 50,000 as father is resident senior citizen. As father is resident senior citizen. I hope you are getting the issue. Grandparents is not covered in category A, nor covered in category B. Therefore, no deduction at all. Grandparents not covered in category A, nor covered in category B. Therefore, no deduction at all. How much is the total deduction? Total deduction is 75,000. Yes, if question is silent, always assume dependent. If question is silent, always assume dependent. Any ifs and buts? Any ifs and buts? What if both are non-resident? Limit is 25,000. Next example. Next example, beta. What would be your answer? What would be your answer in example one if father is also non-resident? क्या आंसर होता बेटा? क्या आंसर होता? कैटेगरी ए डिडक्शन. $25,000. कैटेगरी बी डिडक्शन. $25,000. Category A, 25,000. Category B, 25,000. Total 50,000. Total 50,000. I hope you are getting the issue. I hope you are getting the issue. Shall I move on? Daughter, beta, children may be married, unmarried, major, minor, dependent, independent. Always consider in category A. Children may be minor, major, dependent, independent. Always consider in category A. Sorry, nanny person gift does not include NRI. Gift does not. From Finance Act 2019, now it is included. Sir, mother is non-resident, also covered in category B. Yes, beta, I told you earlier, na? Parents shall always covered in category B. Here, I'm repeatedly again. Children may be dependent, may be independent, may be minor, may be married, may be non-resident, may be resident. Children may be any person. Any other query, beta? Any other query in premium? Shall I move on? Can premium of son be shifted to category B if deficit not at all? One cannot be shifted to two, two cannot be shifted to one. Not at all. Premium of one category cannot be shifted to another category. Grandparents can claim deduction only when amount is paid by them. Grandparents can claim deduction only when health insurance premium is paid by them. Question will beta provide you. Question will definitely provide you whether person is resident or non-resident. As in case of MCQ, you cannot assume. In exam, language would be clear. In exam, language would be crystal clear, beta. There would not be any ambiguity. Any ifs and buts? So if any person include NRI in case of gift, then why there is a separate donor beta? Have you read section 9? If a person is residing in USA, receive gifts in USA, then there may be a situation, might be such income would not be taxable in India. If a person in USA receive gifts in USA, then might be there will be a situation such income would not be taxable in India. In order to tax such person, section 9 is amended. First read section 9, beta. Sir, how category A 25,000? What does it mean? What does it mean, Gaurav? How category A means what? Deduction, I told you, beta, actual premium paid or 25,000, whichever is less. Actual premium paid or 25,000, whichever is less. And whichever is less amounting to rupee 25,000. Any ifs and buts in this question? Any query in this question? Second, deduction on account of medical expense. Deduction on account of health care expense or medical expense, also known as preventive health checkup, also known as preventive health checkup. Category A and category B. In case of category A, who is covered in category A, beta? Assessee, spouse, their children. Assessee, spouse and their children. Actual expense or rupee 5,000, whichever is less. For entire category A, actual expense or rupee 25,000, whichever is less, shall be allowed as a deduction. Category B, exact same. Actual expense or rupee 5,000, whichever is less, shall be allowed as deduction. Fine, beta. This one is category A, actual expense or 5,000, whichever is less. This one is category B, actual expense or 5,000, whichever is less. Most important thing, listen me carefully. Most important thing, this deduction is not extra. This deduction is not extra. This deduction is not extra. What does it mean? It is in the overall limit of. This is in the overall limit of 25,000 or 50,000, as the case may be. Don't consider it as 50 plus 5. No, don't consider it as 25 plus 5 or 50 plus 5. Not at all. This deduction is in overall limit of. This deduction is in overall limit of 25 or 50. This deduction is in overall limit of. This deduction is in overall limit of 25 or 50, as the case may be. 25 or 50, as the case may be. I hope you're getting the issue. I hope you're getting the issue. Listen me carefully. Example. इसको draft करते हैं बेटा. Category A. No one is resident senior citizen. Category A, no one is resident senior citizen. कोई भी बेटा resident senior citizen नहीं है. All person are below 60 year बेटा. All person are below 60 year. Health insurance premium. Paid 30,000. Preventive health checkup. $9,000. Compute deduction under section 80D. Assume there is category A only. Assume there is category A only. Assume there is category A only. Now, health insurance premium. Milan, I will let you know beta later on. I will let you know later on the amendment. In category A, assessee himself, spouse and dependent children. In category B, parents. Parents may be dependent, parents may be independent. That I will let you know in the last. In category A, assessee, spouse and dependent children. In category B, the parents. Parents may be dependent, parents may be independent. That I will let you know in the last. Fine? Now listen me carefully. Health insurance premium. $30 or $25, whichever is less. $25 capacity exhaust beta. So what about preventive health checkup? Nil. No expense shall be allowed. So total deduction under section 80D, total deduction under section 80D 25,000. Why nil? As overall deduction cannot exceeds 25. As overall deduction cannot exceeds by 25. The 5,000 limit is already included in 25 limit. 5,000 limit is already included in 25 limit. I hope you are getting the issue. Example 2. Category A. Other than senior citizen. Category AA, other than senior citizen. Health insurance premium 10,000. Preventive health checkup 9,000. Just do it, beta. Just do it. So first, health insurance premium 10 or 25, whichever is less. 10,000. Now consider preventive health checkup. Now consider preventive health checkup. 9,000 or 5,000, whichever is less. 5,000. Total deduction 15,000. Any ifs and buts in this category? Any ifs and buts in example 2? Any ifs and buts, beta? Yes, today is the last class, beta. I'm teaching you, beta, ATD. You are talking about nonsense last class or not? Any ifs and buts in ATD example 2? Son, maybe I dropped it. Son, maybe step. Son, maybe any, beta. All included in category A. Why 5,000? Actual expense or 5,000, whichever is less. Now, example 3. Category A. Health insurance premium 22,000. Preventive health checkup 7,000. Take your proper time. Health insurance premium 22,000. Preventive health checkup 7,000. What would be the answer? Preventive health checkup. PHC means preventive health checkup. Health insurance premium 22 or 25, whichever is less. 22. Preventive health checkup 7,000 or 5,000, whichever is less. Although it comes to 5,000, but I cannot claim 5,000 as total deduction cannot exceeds by 25,000. So 3,000. This is example 3. I hope you are getting the issue. बेटा नील ओवरऑल इज 25,000 ना, डिडक्शन कैन नॉट क्लेम एक्सीड्स बाय 25,000 इन एनी केस. 25,000 इज ऑलरेडी बीन एग्जॉस्टेड. 25,000 हैज ऑलरेडी बीन एग्जॉस्टेड इन हेल्थ इंश्योरेंस प्रीमियम. देन पीएचसी ऑटोमेटिक नील. As total amount cannot exceeds by 25,000 in any case. Total deduction cannot exceeds by 25,000 in any case. Beta, why don't you follow my words? Beta, total deduction cannot exceeds by 25,000. Total deduction cannot exceeds by 25,000. Had it be 5,000, then total amount would be 22 plus 5, 27, which is not possible. Overall deduction is 25,000. Shall I move on? Now, major amendment, category A, category B. Who is included in category A? SSC, spouse, children. Who is included in category B? Dependent parents. Now please listen me carefully. The word dependent has been deleted and it is placed here. The word dependent has been deleted from category B. Now parents may be dependent. Children now must be dependent. This is the major point earlier. Dependent parents are considered, but word dependent has been deleted, beta. Now parents are considered. Parents may be dependent, parents may be independent. As far as children is concerned, he must be dependent. Now, final example. Mr. X is 40 years resident in India. Provide the following information. Mr. X, health insurance premium 8,000. Mrs. X, health insurance premium 7,000. Dependent daughter, health insurance premium 6,000. Independent son, 9,000. Dependent mother, 59 years, 18,000. Independent father, 62 years resident, 16,000. Now compute deduction under section 80D. Now covered in category A, not covered. Independent son not covered. how much? Actual premium paid, 807.15 or 621 or 25, whichever is less. 21,000. Parents always covered, whether dependent or independent. And mind it, resident senior citizen. Father is resident senior citizen. So ATD. 34,000 or 50,000, whichever is less. 34, 21. So total deduction. Total deduction. How much? 55,000. I think this is more than enough in ATD, beta. ATD completely exhausted. Mother or father, if anyone is senior citizen, not only mother. Mother or father, if anyone is of senior citizen, age 60 or more, then limit is 50,000. $5,000 per category subject to 25,000. This is an overall limit of 25. Scroll down or scroll up. Yes, this one is the example. Municipal law before exam. Shall I move on? Next, beta. Newly incited section from Finance Act 2019. Section 80. EEA, newly incited section by Finance Act 2019. Yes, independent children are now not covered. Only dependent children shall be considered. Fine. This one is latest amendment by Finance Act 2019. Newly incited deduction. Eligible assessee. Just write it down. Eligible assessee individual. Eligible assessee individual only. What is this deduction, beta? This deduction is on account of interest on loan for house property. This is on account of interest on loan for house property. Eligible assessee individual only. Condition. Individual must obtain loan for residential house property. individual must obtain loan for residential house property. Loan should be borrowed from. Loan should be borrowed from bank, financial institution. Individual must obtain loan for residential house. Individual must obtain loan for residential house. Loan must be borrowed from bank or financial institution. Loan must be borrowed. Loan must be borrowed on or after 1st April 2019, but up to 31st March 2020, that is in previous year 1920. Assessee must obtain a loan for residential house property. Loan should be borrowed from bank and financial institution. Loan must be borrowed on or after 1st April 2019, but up to 31st March 2020. Yani ki loan must be obtained in previous year 1920 and stamp value of house does not exceed. Stamp value of house does not exceed 45 lakh. Stamp value of house does not exceed 45 lakh. Beta, in your syllabus previous year 1920. As far as 1920 is concerned, limit is 31st March 2020. In your syllabus, Finance Act 2019, is applicable. And as far as Finance Act 2019 is applicable, prescribed time period is 1920. Fine? Next, beta. If all of the above mentioned points are satisfied, then deduction shall be available. How much? How much is the amount of deduction? Actual interest liability or ₹1,50,000 or ₹1,50,000, whichever is less, fine. Yes, property must be self occupied. Yes, important note. Property must be self occupied. In case of let out, no deduction at all, beta. In case of let out, entire interest is allowed. No need of section 80EEA. In case of self-occupied property, there is upper cap of 2 lakh. That's why law has to introduce section 80EEA. So important note, beta. Such property must be self-occupied by owner. Now listen me carefully. Actual interest liability or ₹1,50,000. Whichever is less. Now please listen me carefully. If we're talking about interest on self-occupied property, if we're talking about, better please wait. What the hell is this going on? Please wait. Interest on self-occupied property, we have two sections. Section 24 and section 80 EEA. In section 24, actual interest or 2 lakh, whichever is less allowed. 80 table A, interest or 1.5 lakh, whichever is less allowed. First, you have to claim under section 24. First, you have to claim under section 24. Only then remaining interest can be claimed under section 80 EEA. First, you have to claim interest under section 24 up to 2 lakh. In excess of 2 lakh, interest can be claimed under section 80 EEA. Mind it, beta? First, interest should be claimed under section 24. Thereafter, remaining interest thereafter remaining interest if any shall be claimed under section 80 EEA. Thereafter, remaining interest, if any, shall be claimed under section 80 EEA. What does it mean? What does it mean? Let us discuss with the help of an example. All conditions of 80 EEA are satisfied and total interest is 1 lakh, 2 lakh, 2 lakh 80,000, 3 lakh, 3.5 lakh, 4 lakh, 5 lakh. All the conditions of section 80 EEA are satisfied. All the conditions of section 80 EEA are satisfied. Total interest is 1 lakh. What is the answer? Claim under section 24. Claim under section 24. Number two, 2 lakh claim under section 24. 2.8 lakh. 2 lakh under section 24. 80,000 under section 80 EEA. 3 lakh, 2 lakh, 1 lakh. 2 lakh under section 24, 1 lakh under section 80 EEA, 3.5 lakh, 2 lakh, 1.5 lakh, up to 2 lakh under section 24, 1.5 under section 80 EEA. I hope you are getting the issue. 4 lakh. 4 lakh. So what should be the answer? 2 lakh under section 24. 1.5 lakh under section 80 EEA. Remaining interest not allowed. remaining interest not allowed lapse. 5 lakh, 2 lakh under section 24, 1.5 lakh under section 80EEA, balance lapse. Balance lapse. I hope you are getting the issue. First, you have to exhaust section 24 limit of 2 lakh. Thereafter, you can claim 1.5 lakh under section 80EEA. 80EEA is in addition to section 24. 80EEA is in addition to section 24 just to provide the benefit. Just to provide the benefit to assessee. I'm letting you know, beta, just to provide the benefit. One under section 24 and one under section 80EEA. It came in election time, beta. Section came in election time. Am I not audible properly, beta? Fine. Any ifs and buts in 80EEA? Any ifs and buts in 80EEA? Shall I move on? Yes. Again, new section 80EEB. Loan taken, interest on loan taken for electric vehicle. Interest on loan taken for electric vehicle introduced by Finance Act 2019. Government wants to promote the use of electric vehicle as it does not cause pollution. Eligible SSE. Individual only. Eligible assessee, individual only. Condition. Condition, individual. Must obtain loan for purchase of electric vehicle. Individual must obtain loan for purchase of electric vehicle. Loan must be sanctioned on or after 1st April 2019, but up to 31st March 2023. But up to 31st March 2023. अमाउंट ऑफ डिडक्शन एक्चुअल इंटरेस्ट लाइबिलिटी और ₹1,50,000 whichever is less. Actual interest liability or ₹1,50,000 whichever is less. Note, double deduction not allowed. What does it mean? If a SSC has already claimed deduction under the head PGBP or might be under the head other source, if a SSC use such vehicle in his business or profession, if a SSC use such vehicle in his business or profession, he has already claimed deduction. He has already claimed deduction under the head PGBP. Then deduction under this section shall not allowed. So point number one, double deduction not allowed. Point number two, amount of loan or price of vehicle shall have no relevance. Just write it down, beta. Amount of loan or purchase price of vehicle shall have no relevance. Fine. This is all about ATEEB. This is all about ATEEB. Major amendment in chapter 6A. Although there are two more amendments, but not relevant beta for executive point of view. Although there are two more amendments, but not relevant from executive point of view. Note 2 is, what is the note 2 beta? Amount of loan and purchase price of vehicle. Amount of loan and purchase price of vehicle shall have no relevance. Vehicle may be of 2 lakh, 5 lakh, 10 lakh, 40 lakh, 1 crore, may be of any amount. Purchase price of vehicle shall have no relevance. Fine. This is all about chapter 6A. Two more amendments are there, but not relevant for your exam. Like ATLA, newly introduced section ATLA, but not relevant for executive. So now your query session beta one by one. Your query session one by one, 1.5 hour exclusively for query session as told by me beta. Now query session beta one by one, any ifs and buts from any of the chapter. Any ifs and buts from any of the chapter. Custom act briefly. Custom will be taken in last beta. Actually, custom is not relevant for all syllabus. Janvi in the last beta. In last. Queries one by one beta.